So let's talk about risk, because it does come back to risk at some point or another. That's what got us all into trouble a few years ago, 10 years ago or so, right? As you look at that growth pattern, can you achieve the growth that you need to, you hope to achieve, without taking substantially more risk on? And I say that in part because you're in a competitive business. And it's not just the other big banks you're competing against. You're competing against non-banks. Mm-hmm. You're talking about all sorts of different institutions. Can you do that without taking that risk on that you got rid of?
So one is, when we talk about our firm and the focus that's there, it's as much about what you don't do as what you do. And a couple things we did is, one is we narrowed the scope of our business from a product perspective, but probably as or more importantly, we radically shrunk the number of institutional clients that we deal with. So roughly the time I became CEO, we were dealing with about 32,000 institutional clients around the world. That number is about 13,000 today. So in there, again, not this long tail of risk. But again, understanding, or we understand, that when you're in a bank, or the things that we do in markets and lending, and those, you're in the risk business. But those risks can't be outsized to who you are and your capital and your liquidity and your earnings. And, you know, we'll, along the way, we'll kind of nick our toe, but as any risk organization can or will, but they just can't be outsized. And I think pre-crisis, what you saw in terms of leverage and balance sheets and concentration of risk, you saw an industry, and certainly from our perspective, a company that had gotten outsized to a lot of those things I described. Something we pay attention to. We operate in a lot of interesting, a lot of challenging places around the world, and it's a perspective we've got to have because we're there and we're committed to those places.